War of the Planet of the Apes. Now, War of the Planet of the Apes is the third movie in the Planet of the Apes franchise remake that they've been doing. The second and third one were directed by Matt Reeves, starring Andy Serkis. Now, the premise of this movie, this is the third one. This has led up to a war. Humans and apes are now fighting over what's left of the Earth, and as much as you'd figure it to be a war film, Caesar, the main ape, decides to leave and chase down the main general dude who killed his family, and now it's revenge. That's the basis. There's a lot of little things that happen into it. Now, let's talk about the things I liked about this. Well, let's talk about things I didn't like about this film. Things I didn't like. There were some pacing issues. There were a couple moments where I was like, okay. And I understood from the nerd perspective that they did some very artistic things to leave moments for you as a fan. If you're a fan, there's a lot of moments for you that you'll love. If you're not a fan, I could notice those moments being obnoxious. The music was awesome. The acting was really good. I don't know, it's just an epic. So, things I liked. Acting was good. Music was epic. The writing and directing was solid. It was such a good film. The graphic and animations in this was incredible. Andy Serkis, he always deserves an award because you forget that it's Andy Serkis. Like, he's played Golem and you forget it's Golem. You know, just the way he does his characters are so legendary and so legit. He does really good. And Woody Harrelson as a bad guy is really good. He's got a conviction of a bad guy that you just love to hate to love. He's just, oh, awesome. So I'm going to give this two ratings because there is a nerd side of this and then there's the movie side of this. So being a fan of the original Planet of the Apes and what they've done with the franchise, I'm giving it two thumbs up. Now, I'm going to separate that and say, if you're a fan, you're going to love it. Now, if you're not a fan of the franchise, and you could care less about apes fighting, I'm giving it a thumbs up, because it's still a really good movie. They do a lot of fan service in this, but they don't forget the main plot and point and subplots. All the characters have this wonderful crescendo, and at the end, you feel accomplished. It doesn't matter if you're a fan of the franchise or not, you feel accomplished, like it was done. If you haven't seen the trilogy, I recommend it. Start with Rise of the Planet of the Apes with James Franco and go through. It is a roller coaster. One of the best trilogies that has come out in a long time. That's not a superhero. That's not Batman. We don't talk about that. So, parental rating, it is rated PG-13. This is a war film, so it's your basic war, you know, torturing people and all that stuff. It's really not that gruesome. It's intense, but it's not gruesome. I don't know. It just isn't a movie that kids would, at least kids now, would have the attention span to sit down and watch. I just don't see it. If your kid's 13, he'll be fine. There's no language, there's no sexual content. It's really just an epic. And you're in this epic for the roller coaster. So that's my review for War of the Planet of the Apes. I would love to hear your thoughts on the Planet of the Apes series in a whole. A lot of people don't like them. I'm a fan of the first couple with the Charlton Heston back in the day. After that, they start getting repetitive, and you're like, wow, do we really need five? No, we don't. So, yeah, so I'm a fan of it, and I really like it, and I think these did great justice. I'd love to hear your thoughts about this trilogy and how it fits with the originals. Put those in the credits. And also, if you haven't, please subscribe. It keeps everything going, keeps me moving and doing stuff. And if there's any movies or reviews you want me to do, throw them in the comments, and I will do them. Thank you so much, and in the end of the day, War of the Planet of the Apes.